to Gia's World. I hope you guys are enjoying all of my videos and aren't forgetting for even a second to like all of my videos, share them with your friends, and hitting the subscribe button below. In this video, I will be making this slip fish bracelet. This is a reversible bracelet, so you can wear it on both these sides. So this is one of the sides. It's all fishtail, while the other side is all slip knots. I have other samples to show you, like this one. You might have noticed that in this one, I used two different colors for the borders, white and yellow, while in this one, I use only one color, silver. If you're wondering how to get one color for the border, then just use only the color that you want for the border instead of using two colors. In this tutorial, I will be making this one with you guys, which has two different colors for the border. So let's get started. If you happen to have a loom like mine, go to the side with the arrow and go to the outer peg line and count 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. If you don't have a loom like mine, then go to the side in which the U shape is pointing away from you and go to the outer peg line and count 8. So now let's start making the cap bands, which on this bracelet are silver and red, and on this bracelet are white and yellow. So from the 8th peg that we counted, take a black band and stretch it across all 5 of these pegs, just like this. And now take another black band and from the 8th peg, go diagonally up right and place a twisted band like that. So you should have something like a figure 8 on those two pegs. Now take a colored band and from this peg, go upwards right and place a twisted band like that, and take a black band and do the same step again. Take a colored band and from this peg go upward right diagonally and place a twisted band, and take black and from this peg to this peg place a band just like that. So now you should have 2 layers of bands on your pegs. So now we are going to take another black band and stretch it horizontally on all 5 of these pegs, just like that. And now we can actually start the hooking process. So take this bottom layer of black band and slide it over those 2 layers of bands that we placed, like that. And now we are going to hook these bands. So go inside the horizontal band and grab this black band and take it out and over. And in case your band untwists, you can just twist it and hook it on. It is a bit hard to hook twisted bands. And now take the jelly purple and blue band and hook it on. And again, if it untwists, you can just twist it and place it back on. Black, twist it and place it on itself. Take the purple and blue and place it onto itself. making sure that it is twisted, and you can stretch it with your fingers and place it if that helps. And on this peg, you can go from like here, but I think it's more easier to go inside from here, go around and grab the black band and take it out, and then place it and twist it, and like that. Make sure your bands are twisted. So now we're gonna take a pink band, and where you should be putting the black, where the black band was, take, stretch it normally without twisting it on those two pegs. Now take a black band, and from this peg go diagonally up to the right and place a black band. Do the same step with the pink, and then take a black from this peg, go diagonally up right and place a band, take pink, and do the same step again, just like that. Now take another black band and stretch it horizontally on all five of these pegs, just like that. And now take the bottom layer of the black, horizontal black band, and take it up and over. Now you can see that we have three layers of bands on all of these five pegs. So take the bottom layer of bands, which on this peg is black, and just slide it up and over normally. And take the bottom purple and blue band and slide it on top normally. Take the black, do the same step again. Take the purple and blue, do the same step again. And take the bottom black and do the same step again. Now we're going to hook these pink and black bands. So go inside the horizontal band, grab the pink band, and hook it up and back onto itself. Now take this black band and hook it back onto itself. The bands are loose on these pegs, so just make sure they don't fall off. And take the pink band and slide it back onto itself. Pink, black band, slide it back onto itself. And then go around, grab that pink band, and take it back onto itself. Now you have three layers, so take the bottom black band and slide it on top of the two pink bands. Now take the purple and blue and slide it on top of the black. Take the black, slide it on top of the pink, and take the purple and blue, slide it on top of the black. Take the black, slide it on top of the pink. Now take a black band, and where you just hooked the pink band, place it horizontally up to diagonally up to the right peg and leave the band there. Now take a purple and blue band, I'm just gonna call it purple, and place it from this peg diagonally up to the right peg, and then take black. Do the same step again. Take purple and do the step again. Take black and do that same step again. Now we're gonna place a horizontal band again on these five pegs like this. And we're gonna start the hooking process. So take this bottom layer of horizontal black band and just slide it on top. And now you should have three layers on your loom on these five pegs. So take the bottom pink band and take up and over, bottom black band up and over, bottom pink up and over, black up and over, pink up and over, just like that. And then take this black band, hook it onto itself, its purple band, hook it onto itself, black, hook it onto itself, black, hook it onto itself, black, hook it onto itself. And take this bottom pink band and slide it on top. Bottom black band, slide it on top. Bottom pink band, slide it, oops. See, the bands are loose, so make sure they don't fall off like that. Slide it back on, and then push it down. And then take the bottom pink band, slide it on top. Bottom black band, slide it on top. Bottom pink band, and slide it on top. And you're gonna keep doing those same exact steps until it gets out of your, like it goes through your loom and it can, like you can fit it onto your wrist, and I'll show you how to close it. So I think I need a couple more layers, so I'll do those with you guys, and then we can work on closing the bracelet. So take a pink band, and from here to here, place it normally like that. Take a black band, and from here, go right to up to the diagonal peg, and then take pink, do the same step again. Take a black from this peg, go diagonally up right, and place, stretch the band on top, and take a pink and do the same step again. Now take another black band, and from here to here, stretch one black band just like that. Now we can start the hooking process. So take this bottom layer of horizontal black band and slide it on top of all of the bands. Next, take this bottom black layer of band and place it on top. And then do the same on all of the other pegs. Just like that. We'll do one more layer, and then we'll close the bracelet. So now take this pink band out and hook it back onto itself, black onto itself, pink, hook it back onto itself, black, hook it back onto itself, and go around, grab the pink band and hook it back onto itself. Now grab the black band on top, purple band, slide it on top. Black band, slide it on top. Purple, slide it on top. And black, slide it on top. Let's do all those steps one more time. So take a black band, and from here, stretch it over here, and take a purple band, and from here, go diagonally upright, stretch one band like that. Take black and do the same step again. Take purple, do the same step again, and do the same step on the next peg. Just like that. Now take another black band and stretch it on all five of these pegs. Just like that, and then take the bottom layer of horizontal black band and slide it on top. Now take the bottom pink band on top, bottom pink band on top, bottom pink band, top, pink band on top, bottom pink band on top. Now take this black band back onto itself, black onto, purple onto itself, black, purple, whoops, and go around, grab that black, and hook it onto itself. Now take this layer of band, the pink band, and set it on top, pink, black on top, pink on top, black on top, and pink. Okay, so now we are going to start closing it. We have to place the diagonal bands one more time. So take pink, slide it diagonally, black, slide it diagonally, pink, slide it diagonally, black, slide it diagonally, and pink, slide it diagonally. Now you're not going to put the horizontal bands that we used to put on top of these five bands. Instead, you're just going to take the bottom layer of this black band, well, the only layer, and slide it on top. Now take this bottom black band, slide it on top, bottom purple on top, bottom black on top, purple top, black top. Now we're going to take this pink band, slide it on onto itself, black, slide it onto itself, take the pink, slide it back onto itself, take the black, slide it back onto itself, and do the same for the last peg. Just like that. Now we have three layers of bands, so take the bottom black band, slide it on top, bottom purple, slide it on top, bottom black, slide it on top, bottom purple, slide it on top, and black, slide it on top. So now we're going to add the C clips. So take these two layers of bands and put your hook inside those two bands and just stretch it onto the next peg, just like that. And now take your C-clip and just place it on there, just like that. And then you can take everything off, like that band off, and then do the same step with these two black bands. Just go inside those black bands, stretch it onto the next peg, take your C-clip, and just clip it on like that. And take everything off that loom, and take the pink band, stretch it onto the lower peg, and then take your C clip and just clip it on there. Just like that. Take everything off your loom. The same step for the two other pegs or bands. Like that. And then you can take this off your loom too. And then you can just pull it through like that. So now just stretch it a bit and tug at it so that the bands aren't like bended or anything, like that. So grab a C clip and grab a cap band across from the C clip that you're holding, and stretch the cap band across your fingers like that. So you should have something like this. And then grab the C clip and just clip it on there like that. And then do the same steps again for all of the other ones. Locate a C-clip and a cap band and grab it and stretch it between your fingers and just hook the C-clip on the band. So grab the black cap band, stretch it between your fingers like that. Take the C clip and hook it on there. Do the same with the purple. Stretch it between your fingers. Grab the C clip and hook it on there. Then grab the cap band, the last cap band, and hook it on there, just like that. And there you have your slip fish bracelet. I really like how the pink and the purple and blue tie-dye look together. They're three of my favorite colors. And the black, it makes a really good border color. So yeah, this is another bracelet with the same pattern we made today. You can see that it also has two different colors for the border, and you can see the backside. Yeah, it's like a bunch of slip knots. And yeah, so if you like this video, don't forget to hit the like button, share this video with your friends, and hit the subscribe button down below. And I'll see you next time. Bye!